くぞ。ジェノサイド勝った。
What's up, everybody? Welcome back. This is Forgo, and today we're going to have a little fun and lunatic guild raid using Elizabeth. Now, as you can see, my Elizabeth is just one star, and we're going to see if you can get that 180 million in lunatic mode with a one star Elizabeth, given you have the right characters to help her out. So we're going to jump into guild, and we're going to go against Mega, of course, and we're going to have this on lunatic. Now, I did a pre-recorded run already. I didn't finish it because I want to keep playing expert, because all of my guild, they just can't play lunatic. They don't have Elizabeth, so they just can't do this. Unfortunately, right now she's the only character in the game that has starlight, and if you don't have that, you're just not going to do very well in this at all. We're also going to answer whether or not you really should even be playing this today as well. Now, this is the team that I opted to go with. I just wanted to go with all characters that are in the game. However, Rugal, I know a lot of people aren't going to, you know, they didn't get the memories. Maybe they didn't get the character. He's kind of like a collab. The difference is, I believe he's going to come back. And I actually think some collabs are going to come back, too. A lot of people keep asking about the Seven Knights. I firmly believe Seven Knights is going to come back because it's a Netmarble property. And this game is owned by Netmarble, so I'm pretty sure they're going to come back. But Rugal here will too. I almost bet money. They're very popular characters. They're going to try to make as much money off these characters as they can. So I would imagine the next time we get a BS Syndrome banner, maybe Rugal and Roachy will be available in there. I have no idea. I'm just speculating and hoping. And I did try to do this with Roachy Iori in the leadership. And boy, oh boy, he just died super, super easy. And first we'll just talk about these strikers that I'm using. And the first striker I'm going to be using is Mai. And Mai offers this. Active team members become immune to burn damage for 10 seconds, which doesn't matter, and then recovers their HP by 1.1% every second for 10 seconds. That is a lot of extra HP recovery, and Rugal absolutely does need it, since my Elizabeth is only a one star. I just can't break that meter as fast as what I would like to. And a lot of times what happens is Guild Raid Rugal will do his explosion right on BS Rugal. And boy, he can do a lot of damn damage. And then for Elizabeth, we have a very special striker. And shout out to my buddy Samaz and Discord for throwing this out at me. Didn't mean to do that. Joe here actually recovers active team members' HP by 10% and decreases damage received by 60% for 5 seconds. This is very important because immunity, like having damage immunity and hyper armor against Guild Raid Rugal, doesn't matter. He pretty much bypasses all of it and just does solid damage to you. However, if you have decreased damage received on your stones and the kit of the character, or just from this striker, which is amazing, you're actually going to decrease the damage received whenever Rugal does his explosion. And this will actually help their survivability at the same time. Also, I'll throw out another little tip about some cards here in a second as well. And Zero here is just for extra damage for Guinness. And they do have a link effect. As you can see here, we get the increased attack by 10% of HP at 7% or more. And then our critical rate goes up at 7% or more. And then we get the extra damage from Zero. And Rugal here, obviously, is completely maxed out. I've talked about him a bunch, max capsules, blah, blah, blah. But the thing that I want to point out on him is one of his stones actually decreases damage received by 30%. You know, and that's when he's attacked. This isn't when you're using an awakened skill or nothing like that. And this is actually very good for him because it makes him a lot tankier. Just like I said earlier, decreased damage received, whether you get from your stones, whether it's something in the kit of the character and their core effect or on their active skills, they're going to take less damage. Even from, say, the Einset, they're going to take less damage. Just something to keep in mind if you're having trouble keeping your character alive. And then for the card set, I am running the Akane. Now, the Akane is another little tip I want to throw out at you guys. Something I noticed about the Akane is Say your HP gets drained all the way to nothing. Well, guess what? The immunity from the Akane will actually engage and protect you from dying. Now, this is on a 45-second cooldown, so it's only going to save your butt probably once, because by the time this comes back around, by the time this cooldown finishes, you'll probably end up getting one-shotted the next time Guild Raid Rugal does his explosion. But the fact that it saves you that one time might be the only time you need to get the extra points to get the score that you need. So the Akane set is actually very good for this, especially when you have healing strikers. So I'm healing my characters as I go. I got decreased damage received on Rugal from a stone, and I got the Akane as a little insurance for having the immunity. Plus, it's a great set for damage. And then we get to talking about our girl, Elizabeth. There's plenty to talk about with Guinness here. Just real quick and briefly, max capsules, max imprint stones. I am using a Cosmic card and the PG card. I'm using a Leah set on him because more than likely, whenever I'm running through the skills, it seems like the explosion doesn't really happen to Guinness. It seems like it really just happens to Rugal and Elizabeth. And that's why I have the recovery strikers on those characters. And other than that, Guinness, you know, he has max imprint stones. He's got this stone here from the Expert Guild Raid, this stone from Immortal Victor, and this stone from one of the Immortal Dungeons as well. And now for our girl, Elizabeth. And you notice I got that striker that decreases damage received on her. And the reason is, and by the way, I have no imprint stones on her and I have no capsules on her. So she's just the bare minimum awakened level 10. That is it. But the thing that's really sweet about this girl, and there's a lot of things that's really sweet about her, other than just how she looks. She's actually very beautiful. But the thing that's really nice about her is, you know, on top of the increased attack, based on your defenses and the starlight and the shock, is this decreased damage received by 60%. So even though she's level 10, she can take quite a bit of damage before she dies, which is insane. So say Rugal gets ready to do his explosion. You could always bring in Joe to decrease damage received by 60%, and if you can, try to get in the second skill so you get this decreased damage received by 60% for 4 seconds. One way or another, maybe you'll have decreased damage received, and you're going to increase her survivability big time. You know, she does have the hyper armor, but this just gets bypassed every time Rugal does his explosion, but you do deal the shock damage. I haven't tested Elizabeth in PvP at all because she's just going to get murdered right now, guys. You know, imprint stones are being applied. I'm not going to put her in there. It's not going to be fair at all. I really want to play her when there's things more on a level playing field for her to give her a real fair shot in PvP so I can give you guys an accurate assessment of what I actually think about her in PvP. But I am running the Akane set for the same reasons I just talked about with the immunity. So it's going to be her saving grace if she gets down to 1% HP. This will save her, and it's going to give you maybe an extra round of doing damage. And then we got a cooldown. We got a PG card on her. Then, by the way, something else that's really sweet about this character is a lot of times I use a PG striker in these things, and she just doesn't need it. Because even though she doesn't have any PG rate in her core, she's got PG rate. Well, she does have PG rate in her core. She just doesn't have a PG rate, a PG charge rate. But she does gain 10% power during 20 or more combos on a 20-second cooldown when HP is 30% or more. And this will always be up because every time you run through your skills, you know, you run through, you know, my first character, Rugal, I use Elizabeth, then I use Guinness, and I go back to Rugal. That, you know, between the using all the ultimate skills, this 20-second cooldown is going to be refreshed. So she's just going to keep gaining all that PG every time you bring her back in, which is amazing. She just builds up her PG super, super damn fast. And if you're going to use her in a leadership role, yeah, she's going to be pretty insane. I really would love to level this character up and see what she can really do. It does suck she's got a 5 PG, but just like Jeanette, because of the building up PG on doing those combos, she builds up her PG super freaking fast. You're going to see in Guild Raid, she's insane. Her Infinity is completely maxed out. But so far, I'm loving Elizabeth. And before we jump into this run, I want to talk about something really quick. And I mentioned this in the last video. You know, in Lunatic, You know, you can get these stones, right? You can get all these attack stones, double attack for burn and double attack for bleed and double attack for the starlight, right? You can get all those stones. You got gold hammers and level 4 experience balls and so on and so on, right? And that's great. I'm pairing kits. But the thing is, you have all of these things in expert mode, except for the starlight dot. Well, except for the bleed, except for the stones with bleed. But you have stones with the burn and the starlight. These stones are in here. So my question is, do you really think it's worth it to get Elizabeth just to play the lunatic mode? Personally, I don't think it's really worth it, because as you all know, I've tested all these stones in the past. I've tested the dot effects and stacking and all that, and dot effects do stack. But I mean, if you have two stones with double attack on a character, and then you have one stone that has the dot effect, it's still going to be better than having three stones that have HP and attack, HP and attack, and then another HP and attack with all the same dot effect. You're still going to get more damage having two double attack stones with one stone that just has the dot effect, because increasing your attack actually does increase the amount of dot that you're doing. So I actually think Lunatic is kind of not a waste of time, because I do believe you have higher chances of getting a good stone. It's just, we only have one character that has Starlight. And yeah, if you're able to play Lunatic, maybe it's going to prepare you a little bit faster for other Starlight characters that are going to come into the game. Like, and I'm betting money, it's going to be Athena, and maybe even when the Seven Knights come back. But I just don't think it's really all that relevant right now. I really don't. I think everybody should just keep playing on expert. I mean, obviously, if you can play Lunatic, right? If you can play Lunatic and you can get that 714 million throughout the day, you know, I got a player in my guild, shout out to him, Sugio, because he's getting, you know, 344 million in this thing. But a lot of players are not going to be able to do that, and they're just going to have to play on expert because they don't have Elizabeth. They're trying to save their rubies for the collab. And what I'm just trying to tell you all is, I wouldn't sweat it. I really wouldn't. I can even get the 180 million four times a day if I really want to, but I want to keep playing expert mode, because if I don't play expert, that's going to screw my other guild mates out of getting double the rewards. Because if you get the max amount of damage, you know, if you end up ending all of this, you do all this damage, you're going to get double the boxes. So I want to make sure these guys and expert are getting those boxes. I want to make sure that's my first priority. And then if I can do Lunatic, I will. So let's jump into the action and let's rock and roll. So I only did this run one time. This is just a one-time shot, so I definitely could perfect it if I want. But like I said earlier, I'm not going to really be playing this. I'm just going to keep playing expert. And look at how fast she built that freaking default PG up. Look at that. Already, that is crazy. I'm just going to forward around a little bit. Then we're going to hit the 3 to get the hyper armor. Then go into the 1. Then we're going to bring in Guinness. Oh yeah, and I do have the Leah set on Guinness. We're going to do our 3 PG. And then we're going to switch to Rugal. Build up his 3 PG and let it go. And you guys have all seen this over and over, this, you know, these kind of runs. But I'm telling you guys, I tried this with Iori. Oh my God. Literally, I even built a stone for Iori and slapped it on him, a decreased damage received stone. And still, 2 shots from Rugal, 2 explosions, and Iori was dead. A level 50 Iori with extra HP on his stones, decreased damage received stone, and still 2 shots and he freaking died. It was not good. Now if you have a, you know, 4-star Elizabeth or 5-star leveled up Elizabeth, then maybe you could get away with using Iori, because you're going to break the meter a lot faster. But when you can't break the meter as fast, Rukao does the explosion quite a bit. You know, the decreased damage received stone on BS Rugal is actually helping him quite a bit. I mean, he is a cost 65 character. He does have the extra stats. But that decreased damage received is really helping him. And a lot of times, whenever you switch in Elizabeth, if you're playing this, if you're playing on Lunatic, you really want to get that second skill off as fast as possible so you get the decreased damage received. The only immunity that doesn't get bypassed is the immunity on the Akane set, as far as I know. I'm not sure if the striker bonuses from Rugal and BS Orochi gets bypassed. I don't think they do. I think maybe you can still use them. But more than likely, if you have a BS Orochi and BS Rugal, more than likely you're using them as damage dealers. More than just a striker. Watch out. And I just love the way Elizabeth plays. I love the way she moves, the way she rolls. She really is quality. I'm really looking forward to trying her out in PvP and seeing what she can do. My only, I guess, kind of concern with her is, you know, she has the grab on the third skill, and you need to use the second skill to disable their roll. Well, the second skill doesn't have super armor. Now, there are cards in the game you can use to help with that, so maybe I'll do something like that. We'll see. But you see, my Rugal just took quite a bit of damage, and I absolutely love this skill. It's so beautiful. Look at this. Just sparkles everywhere, man. Whoa! Bastard. Got a hold of me. Let's get him. Come on. I love it when that Leah set procs. And I will be pausing this. I'm not going to finish this fight out. Because again, I don't want to screw my guildmates out of the expert mode. I want to make sure we get all the points so we can get the double the rewards. Get him. And I'm just healing Rugal as we go with my... Boom! Ooh, that was a lot of damage. Damn. Let's go. But I do think it's pretty freaking cool that even with a one-star Elizabeth, you can actually still do this. I mean, look, we're at 174 million right now. We need 180. 180 million. And we do that four times a day, we can get the max score. We can get enough points to get the best box. And we're already at 206 million. Come on. Let's go. Oh, damn. Not good. But I can tell y'all, you know, this was really just for this video. I'm just going to be playing expert probably for a while. It's going to be a good while probably before I ever get this girl at a high enough awakened level where I can do this really comfortably. Or until my guildmates really, catch up a little bit. You know, and there's never no pressure from me. I always say people should enjoy games, play as you want to go. There's never no pressure. Look at Rugal's life. He is about ready to croak. Oh, and he's dead. Not bad, huh? Not bad. We're getting ready to pause this sucker. Oh, damn. And we're just going to go ahead and let go. We had 234 million. And I only need 180 million. So, yeah, you can absolutely use a level 10 Elizabeth with the bare minimum. No imprint stones. Nothing special at all. And you can definitely get it done. I wasn't even using damaged strikers. My strikers, if my Joe... would have been, you know, 5-star. We could have added a lot of extra CP. Could have done even better and still helped our survivability. So it definitely can be done. But again, should you be doing this? Well, it really depends on your guild. And it really depends on you. Personally, I think for most players at this point in the game, especially since Elizabeth just came into the game, I would just kick back, play expert until the guild can catch up, until you can catch up to where you can do lunatic and expert. And try to get all those rewards. So let me know how you're all feeling about level 10 Elizabeth helping to get it done in the lunatic mode. And let me know if you agree with me about playing lunatic. Do you really think it's worth it considering you're going to get the same stones except for bleed stones? And as always, let me know what characters you've gotten, what cards you've gotten. And I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching. Y'all take care and have a good one.